Episode 7 of Let's Platinum Super Time Force Ultra. Alright, so this time we're going to do 3072. Now, I did the first level ages ago, but now we're going to do the second level. And the end, if you remember, I'll say, take the freeway, maybe we can lose all these jokes. If you remember, the reason I didn't do this was because I couldn't reach one of the globes right at the beginning, so I thought, nah, I'll leave it for later, because I thought we might need a different character. Turns out that we actually can just use Jeff Leppard, as I'll demonstrate here in a few moments. So basically, one of my subscribers told me this. You hold the square button, you aim down, you release the square button, and then as you jump, you press... and then, like, just at the last second, press X. It's actually quite difficult to do. I had to try that a few times to actually get it to work properly. And then, excuse me, the extra problem is that once you shoot that... that red barrel there, as you saw, two globes come out, and one of the globes actually ends up being on top of where the other one was, and I was trying to get it. As you can see, I failed twice at the jump, so, and then I tried it again, and then I got it this time, and then just stand there to get it, otherwise it'll break, like you just saw there. Yeah, so it's a tricky jump to do, but basically you hold square, aim downwards, release square first, don't jump first. That's pretty much the only thing I can kind of tell you to give you any sort of an idea of how you want to perform it. But, you know, try it a few times, you'll probably eventually get it. That was one of my subscribers that actually told me how to do that, so thank you. Chris the Stampeder, I think it is. And, yeah, okay, so now... I was actually trying to get the Headbanger Trophy. Apparently, also Chris Stampeder told me this, you hold square and then you jump on people's heads, and then with Shieldy Blockerson. You could do it with a few other characters too. But you hold square, jump on the heads, and then you can get the trophy. But for some reason, I couldn't get the trophy with Shieldy Blockerson. I have no idea why. Yeah, just doesn't make sense. So, luckily what I did was I was trying to get that glob first. Luckily what I did was, I was trying to think, this glob, I was like, how am I going to get this? And then I was like, wait, can't the journey character double jump? So I jumped, grabbed it, and then I leaped again, I failed, I died, and then I was like, oh wait, it doesn't really matter, I can just do that, and then, yeah, and then do that. Okay, now, here's another thing. I get two trophies one after the other here. The first one is Headbanger, which is the one I was trying to do. Yeah, and you can apparently do it on those. So that doesn't really make sense, but yeah, you can apparently do it on those. And then what I did was I saved my character from Journey and teamed him up with the character from Journey, technically, and I got Don't Stop Believing. So, to get that first trophy, Headbanger, use the character from Journey, at least it worked for me straight away. Just jump on one of those projectiles or on an enemy. Literally, you just have to press X and jump on their head. You don't have to like press any buttons or anything like that. And then, to get Don't Stop Believing, make sure that you use the character from Journey. Die in a particular way. I'd say like try and get killed by those bullets like I did. And then reverse time to, you know, a substantial point, and then use the character from Journey again. Save your first character by destroying the bullet by jumping on top of it, or using whatever means you can to get it, and then team up save the character from Journey with the character from Journey, and you'll get Don't Stop Believing. Alright, so now we're pretty much at the end of the stage already. I got all three shards, I have 8 globes, I believe I get all the globes in this stage, so the last two should be here. Don't think I missed it. There, you can see it also there, I just jumped on the bullet with Ludon Jim, but it doesn't work. He doesn't, like, sort of destroy the bullet. He's jumped, so yeah. The interesting thing about this game, I think, is that a lot of the characters have very obvious different traits that they share. So like, for example, Jeff Leppard has, you know, projectile, what would you call it, like just rocket attacks, where you can press square once and do a nice strong rocket attack that's curved, has like a curved trajectory, and then you can also hold square to do more damage with like a stronger one that travels straight. But then he also can like jump higher by using that special ability. And then you have a character like Journey who really can't like damage enemies, I don't think. Or, you know, he has that kind of like the scarf attack, I guess. But he can like jump on people's heads, even though you would think, for example, Jeff Leppard could probably jump on heads, but I think he dies if you try and do it. So yeah, there's like major differences that are noticeable and subtle differences that are less noticeable. So I think it makes the game pretty interesting. All right, so for this boss, yeah, this boss was actually quite tricky. I mean, I already got one glob. Yeah, I got like not confused, but it was just like I was like, why am I still fighting this boss? It took me forever to kill him. Yeah, and then I just kept trying to do damage with Chili for some reason. Reversed all the way back just to get enough characters going. The trick is to try and let each character survive as long as possible. If you can do that, there we go, got the final glob, and then the mission is complete. Hooray! This actually ends up being, oh wow, 1-1-1-1-1. I didn't even notice that the first time when I was playing it. Okay, so we unlocked Squirty Harry for getting 50% of the shards? Yeah, shards. Alright. Okay, I jacked into that Swaz van's GPS and set the coordinates for the Google HQ. Just keep the van on the road, sky, long enough to get there. Well, it's not even Google, it's Google. Google is one with 100 zeros in front of it. Hence why Google is called Google, because it has like 100 results. Nah, probably not that much, but it has a lot. Okay, so here I was just trying Squirty Harry just to see what he was like, and also for one of the trophies, but I think it's not gonna work, so I just tried Cleo. Cleo works pretty well here. Spam the square button. Fire boomerangs at everything. I was really annoyed by this stage because I get what was trying to happen. Oh, did I restart? Oh, whoops, I forgot to cut that out. Oh, damn. Sorry about that. Alright, yeah, so what I was trying to do was basically, I was trying to, yeah, just spam boomerangs and then attack those enemies, and also I was trying to get all the globs, but this level has an actual, it's very tricky. If you notice at the top of the van, eventually you'll see a glob fly past. Well, there's a shard on the left, but eventually you see a glob fly past, and if you're not up there to collect it, you'll miss it. Like, you can obviously time out and reverse time to go get it, but you'll miss it, and the worst part is that, like, you really, really, really have to pay attention up there so that you don't miss any. Like, I'll keep an eye out now to see which one I missed. There's one. I might have missed that one. I think it was that one that I missed. I'm not 100% sure I did the first time there. Let's find out. Okay, it wasn't that one. I actually saw that one. But there was one that I missed. I don't know if it was one of the ones that I, like, at the top that fly by, but I remember I only got 9 out of 10 for this mission, and I think that's why I got so annoyed, because I was like, ah, that mission was so annoying, and like, long and tough, but, and I have to do it again. Oh no, there's probably no time for this one, like, no time trial. Alright, here we go. Now we're getting somewhere. So, still on 3. I'm so curious as to the one I missed. Shard down there. That was cool. I like jumped off with Jeff Leppard, grabbed the shard, and just destroyed that car at the same time. Ah, got it. Look how many people I saved because of that. Yeah, it's a, like, do not underestimate this mission. It's very, very tough. Okay, there's one, so that was 5. Did I get that one? Reversing now. Oh, yeah, I did. Wow, I went really close with that one. This stage, there's 1-6. And is so tricky. It gets really tricky. Like, I mean, look how many bullets are going everywhere. No wonder I'm dying so much. Now I'm actually curious as to which one I did miss, because it looks like I collected all the ones that were flying towards me, so whatever one I missed must be like on the boss or something. Here's the other thing, like you have to pay attention to that that life bar and make sure that it doesn't go to zero on the top left there, because okay, I got that one, so now I have 8. I did something at the end here, I remember I like did a ton of damage. I could do the damage to the actual truck. Okay, yeah, he destroys the truck here. There's the third shard. Surely could have. I think I could have jumped off that bullet, but I don't think I did. That devil square. Okay, so 9. Wait, did I get it? The boss must have the last one. How do I know that it was the last one? No, the boss didn't have the last one. So where the hell was the last one? I must have missed it by accident. That's really odd. I would have got the orb and shard badge, and I would have completed the level and never had to do it again. Alright, that was a really annoying level. Googleplex! Yeah! So funny, it's like 3072 and Google has taken over the world. Well, not necessarily taken over the world, but they've got like an entire Googleplex. Hello, Super Time Fast. You were expecting the internet? Okay, I'll give you all the internet you can handle. Consider yourselves downloaded. I thought this was a pretty clever level. I really like it. He downloads you into his computer and then you go into like old 90s webpage and stuff like that. Look at this. Just screaming into the 90s. And people like being trying to rename websites for no reason. Because there weren't trophies back then. Alright, so yeah, this, oh yeah, I should explain this stage. Well, not this stage, but just I should explain, what you should do for it. Okay, so basically what you want to do, I hope I'm doing it right here. Oh, I'll explain in a second, because I feel like I edited this correctly. Yeah, okay, I did. What you want to do is you want to kill each boss, especially the ones early on, as fast as possible. So even if you kill it, like let's say you kill it within 10 seconds, just rewind time and just keep attacking it. Just keep doing damage until it dies like in 3 seconds or something like that, or in one big massive damage like here. See, like it almost died instantly in 5 seconds. Well, in like 1 second, because it takes 5 seconds to actually allow you to hit it. I guess it's up 4. Alright, and then just move on. The reason you want to do that is because you run out of, what's it called? Time at the end. This one's a little trickier. You just have to keep destroying the little babies. And, yeah. God, when websites have images, but this is just 81. Maybe that's a reference to, like, someone who made this game's birthday. Seems fair. They'd be, what, 34 now? Jeez. Alright, yeah, so, like, I destroyed all the babies, and then I went all the way back to the beginning, and now I'm just destroying them a little bit quicker, so, yeah, I'm going for that one. I actually ended up going for the same one several times. I think this one's basically based on a, you know, the quicker you destroy them, the quicker they spawn. So I went one more time, just to make sure that they destroyed all quickly. So 53 seconds, I think I was at 39 at the end of it. Sir Galahad might be actually better for this. Just like blasting arc shots everywhere. I was only a little bit faster. Okay, and then this is the third layer, or the dragon's layer. but there's still one more boss after this, so. Yeah, there's still one more boss after this. And it takes a little bit of time to actually deal with, so the faster you can deal with this dragon layer, the better. Sort of similar strategy to the first one, just it's basically designed like that first skull as well, just like trying to make sure that you get enough damage in straight away. That was pretty quick. Yeah, I gave myself essentially like 30 seconds to deal with the last boss. This boss is a little bit tricky, but once you know what to do, all you have to do is just stand on the top, keep destroying these symbols, and then once you've destroyed them, just reverting on the top one and just doing it again with the second Jeff Leopard, so that way you can get more damage. I guess I just let this keep going because I was like, okay. Redo the whole thing with another character and just keep it going, and that way he'll take a lot more damage because he actually lost what, like half his health or something. Now that we have two Jeff weapons, this bit is tricky. You have to kind of like make sure that you're standing on that second platform. Anyway, you'll pretty much get it the more characters you use. Okay, should start taking heavy. There we go, he jumped like straight down. And then make sure you get on here as quickly as possible. And like I said, the more characters you have shooting, it's like a glitch that you clear out, and the more damage you get. There we go, got the glow. Is the shard here? I hope the shard's here. I think it's at the top left. But... apparently I didn't even worry about it. I don't know where the shard is at that level. Alright, so that's that done. And we have Stash. I haven't tried Stash. I don't know what his abilities are or anything. Oh, there we go, year 3072 completed. Same thing for as the other ones. Get like all those commendations. Okay, and that pretty much leaves like one time period to go. Okay guys, get ready. The president said this cat was so cute that even the Secretary of Defense lolled. Oh gosh, that was pretty good, but it would have been better if the cat had nunchucks or tried to do a backflip or something. Oh gosh. Alright, so the only one left is 9600 BC. So I'm just going through like the characters here real quick. Just like skipping through things. And what I decided to do was I went to the first, which level did I go to? Yeah, the first level of 3072 again. Even though I'd completed it, I wanted to get a trophy using Squirty Harry. So what you got to do is basically you got to complete the entire level without dying. You can time out. You can time out. That's the important thing to remember. You can time out. It's just dying that costs you the attempt. I think this is pretty much the best level to do it on, to be honest. It's the, I think it's the first level that you play, or wait, no, you get access to everything, so it's like one of the first levels that you can play, and the reason I think it's the best is because this bit right here is probably the trickiest bit, and all you have to do is jump and press square once to destroy each of those fire-breathing things, and that's pretty much it. You just pass that, you make sure, this was a little bit of a tricky jump, but I don't know how the hell I did that. Good luck getting past that bit. Maybe you want to go in there, quickly destroy all the fire breathing things, destroy that blue thing on the ground, and then just jump down there. One, two, three. It'll take like three bullets, it looks like, but yeah, destroy that blue thing on the ground, jump down, and then you can avoid the bullets simply here. This was, oh boy, this was so lucky. I don't know how I survived this. like I said, as long as you don't die, it's fine. You can use timeout. What I did there was I used the timeout just to make sure that I didn't get hit by those bullets, and also I managed to get the shard there, so I slowed down time and just kept trying to shoot that guy. And I shot him a lot of times, like I got some decent damage on him. And then I couldn't hit him for the life of me. I'm like, why can I not hit him? And I almost got shot there, so I timed out again. One more time, and I got him. Went to the right, jumped on the taxi cab. Mission complete, and I got the runs. Well, I got the trophy, the runs. Alright, and for the rest of this episode, it's just going to be some more helideck missions. It's fun. I actually enjoy them. They're really good. This got a little bit tricky. I took me about 2 minutes to work out what I had to do here. Basically, you have to jump on the bullet and then you can jump up. Otherwise, you won't be able to jump up here. I was like, okay, I see. Same thing. Just gotta wait. Do that. I somehow missed that blob, and then the worst part was like I tried to start from here and I still missed it. So I started from the back. Tried it again and then failed. Then I tried it again and I think I got it this time. I think you may have to do that jump twice in order to kill the guy in one jump, so that both your clone and you jump on him, he takes 2 damage, he dies, and then you can collect the thing. This is really tricky this bit, but I think what you can do is as soon as you land on the first one, if you manage to connect on the head of the first enemy, just keep holding right and it should work. Like, I think they're placed in such a way that you can essentially just keep holding right to get to the end, and I think I demonstrated somewhat. So that's, yeah, it's pretty much what you need to do. And look how much time I had left to collect the So I think that's how it was designed. I don't know, also, you may get the headbanger trophy in that bit there, because you just jump on so many heads. Okay, here, you get one revert. So immediately revert, grab the shard to slow down time, use your attack, send it both ways, and then you'll probably miss one, because there's just not much time, and then revert again all the way to the beginning, hit the other one, and grab the other shard. And remember that when you get a shard, you're allowed one extra revert. So that's how that one works. I'm pretty sure that is the intended strategy to get that. Alright, this one here. Oh, this one was a little bit tricky too. And I got it eventually. It's actually not as tricky to figure out, it's just tricky to pull off. Okay, so here. Shard somehow fails. Actually, it's like I went too quick there. Okay, now it's time out again. I realized I should have used aim. Shoot that. I'm just gonna die. Just missed the wall. So what I decided to do was to go all the way back here, get shield in front of the thing, jump. I think I jump, I just didn't realize it the first time. Yeah, I jumped to kind of I got ahead of it that time. I think I get it this time. There we go. Just jump a little bit to kind of get like closer to it. This was tricky. This actually took me quite a long time, so it's going to take a little bit of time to actually show this off, but it took me quite a long time. Not to get that glow, but to get the last one. Because the thing is, like, there, it's already destroyed, so I had to revert, like, I think I used almost all of them, and I couldn't tell if I was getting there any quicker. Like, I felt like that was slightly quicker, but I'm like, how the hell am I going to get past this? It's just not, like, I'm just gonna... I just kept trying and trying and trying, and I felt like, okay, if I get there at this point, oh, did I go all the way back here? Apparently I went all the way back here. Whoa! Yeah, I think I was trying to work out like where the best position was. Yeah, that was actually good because I lost a lot of time by just walking the rest of that way. just missed it. So I knew, I was like, okay, I'm really close. I'm really, really close. I tried it again. This one, I just went for it. I failed that. I think I was holding the button, but I didn't hold it long enough, or I didn't start early enough. And then I just, got it. It was, that's really tough to get that. I think I got quite lucky to get it there. Alright, and now what's the next one? 19. I'm gonna do 19. This was frustrating, but I, after several attempts, I was just like, okay, what if I do this and this first? Then I revert all the way back to the beginning. Get John Robois. Shoot the switch. Oh, I waited, yeah. I know why I waited. I waited so that, Shieldy, because now I was basically just going to use Shieldy all the way. Jump, use it. And then jump, use it again. And the only reason I didn't get it there was because I got knocked back by one of the bullets. So I just started it right there. It's forward. It's tricky, but yeah, you kind of have to do two and then just walk sort of close to the middle to get it. Alright, and finally, level 20. Alright. Bang. Destroy all these. Definitely destroy all these. It's pretty much suicide to try and get that. I failed this so many times. How do I cut the fail attempt out? Yeah, I couldn't work out how to like get the bullet to go up there. And I tried several times, but I think I eventually get it. I think I eventually figure out. I was like, oh, okay, I have to jump and press square. So I go all the way back here. There we go, yeah. I had to jump and press square. This again, as well, for some reason, my aim was just not straight and true. Curved and true. But yeah, after several rewinds and reflex, I eventually got it. Well, I killed him, but it was way too long. I needed to make sure that I killed him like on the first shot. And I could not find the sweet spot to get it. Some of you will probably get it first go, so just jump, bang, done. That second one I did get first go, and then I was like, oh great, I'm just in the swan. Waited a second, jumped on top of it, which was lucky. And then I got here. This one's pretty easy. Just, yeah, make sure you shoot both the switches. And as long as you have, I think it's 3 reverts, you should be fine. Because, heck, even if you have like 2 or 1, you could still technically be fine. Because every time you collect the glove, you get an extra one. So there we go, went from 7 to 6, then I collected 7 to 6 again. Back to 7. That's pretty much it. That's all I did for episode 7. 28 minutes, pretty good. Unfortunately, sorry about forgetting to cut out that bit in that episode, but yeah. Alright guys, that's it for episode 7 of Lens Platinum Super Time Force Ultra. Thanks for watching. My name is Ultimate416. See you next time.